Yeah, it was a tale of two seasons for the Florida Panthers, as you well know. They really struggled at the start, but turned it on after the All-Star break. One of the best teams in the league in that span. They did fall just one point of making the playoffs. And now we welcome in Nick Bjugstad to talk all things Florida Panthers. So, Nick, first of all, with how close you did come to making the playoffs, does that give you even more motivation to get back to the playoffs next year?
Yeah, it was unbelievably close there at the end. So definitely, optimistic about the future with us, with the season we had last year, and still stings a little bit not making the playoffs. It was tough watching, being that close. So definitely makes you work a little harder and makes you think a little bit about it during the summer. And next year I think we'll all be ready for it.
Nick, tough start to the season. The first half wasn't very good. One of the best teams in the second half of the season. What changed in that dressing room from the first half of the season to the second half?
Yeah, it was kind of a night and day change for us. We really turned it on the second half, and we kind of figured out our systems, and it was just a little bit of an adjustment with the coaching change, and they did a good job with us, and obviously we responded. So the group we have going, it's we all kind of started out together, and we're starting to come together. So we all kind of feel it's time, and we're really excited for what the future holds here.
And you should be. A lot of young talent that you guys have really grown up together. Yourself, guys like Barkov, Trocheck, Huberto, all of you really growing together over the past five seasons. How much has that chemistry changed over the years? And do you feel like you're really hitting your stride together now?
Yeah. I mean, you talk about a guy like Alexander Barkov. He came into the league at 18. And, he keeps getting better and better every year. So you can throw Huberto into that mix, Trocheck, all those guys. Everyone seems to be improving, and really good chemistry off the ice. We all hang out, live close to each other, so definitely a close team, and the camaraderie is there. So it's just a matter of putting it together, and like I said, I think it's time here to really get it going down in South Florida.
Nick, you transitioned from your natural position of center to the wing. How was that transition? You seemed much more comfortable late in the season, but how big of an adjustment was it for you?
Yeah, I changed last season, and it was a little different for me. I played center my entire life, so I had some opportunities to play wing here and there, and started to click a little last season. So, I enjoy it. It's a little different role defensively, so I got to play with Barkov there at the end of the season, him and Dadnoff, so they made it easy for me, and just kind of get open, and they got me the puck. So I'm enjoying the new position, and I think it's good to be able to play a little bit of both.
And who knows, maybe you'll even get to play with Mike Hoffman now, as he is a big name acquisition for your team. What does his presence do for your lineup?
I think everyone, when you think of Mike Hoffman, the first thing you think of is big-time goal scorer. So he's definitely going to help with the depth on our roster. And, I think he's going to definitely contribute for us. So we're looking forward to having a guy like that and adding him to the lineup. It's only going to help us.
Nick, you, Jamie touched on this young group coming together, growing up together. Now, all you guys, 4, 5, 6 years in the league. Do you guys feel that you guys are now the leaders in that locker room?
Yeah, it's been a big turnover since I got there. Me and Barkov came in together. Huberto was there the year before. And, it's definitely changed a lot. But these last few years, we've kind of had the same core. So, I keep pounding it on the nail here. I think it's time for us to really step up. We're getting older. We're not so young anymore, especially in this league. So, it's time for us to step up to the challenge, and I think as the last half of last season was a showing tale of what we can really do here in the future.
Yeah, it makes that off-season training program all the more important, right? And I know that you are very busy playing actual hockey in the summer, because I understand the Beauty League, which is going on in Minnesota, has a lot of NHL guys in it. I know you're taking part in that. Can you tell us more about the league and what you're looking forward to for another year there?
Yeah, it's pretty interesting. The first time it started 2 years ago, the first time I pulled up in the parking lot, I thought I was just going to play a pickup 4-on-4 hockey game, and there, the parking lot was full over at Braemar Ice Arena in Edina. So you pull up and you kind of it changes the pace because the whole arena is sold out, and you know, the kids are into it, and kind of makes everyone else get into it in July. So it's a very competitive league, and definitely good just to try new stuff and kind of get into that competitive flow. And obviously there's tons of guys in Minnesota that play in the NHL and good college hockey players. So good competition to get you ready for the season.
Who are some of the biggest names on your team?
You know what? I haven't seen the roster yet. We start this Wednesday.
and you don't know the roster
year,
yet?
Last year, yeah, I don't know. Actually, my agent, Ben Hankinson, runs it, so he's going to have to give him a hard time for not sending me the roster yet.
But who's your coach?
They have a ton of stuff going on. I don't know. Last year, it was Lott, Brian Lott. So
yeah, yeah.
I don't know if he's coming back. I know he's on the screen. He's big time now. So last year, we ended up winning with him, and we had Eric Halla. We threw TJ Oshie there in the playoffs on our team. I don't think the other guys were very happy about that on the other team. He came right in and helped us. But, yeah, who else did we have? We had a ton of guys. Chorney, Goligoski. We had a pretty good squad. So, and then they throw the college kids in there, too. And they usually end up helping the team the most because they work super hard. And
yeah. They're
usually in mid-season form right in the summer. So, It's a good all-around time for everyone.
That's great. Brian Lawton pulling some moves late in the playoffs to give his team the edge. We love it. I think he is planning on coaching, but so maybe I'm breaking the news to you there. He might be your coach. Either way, the Beauty League starts Wednesday. Good luck, and thanks so much for the time.
Yeah, thanks for having me, guys.